Hello, Mindfulness Project family. I'm super excited right now because now we're starting the practice about conquering your fears. And now I would like to introduce a completely new form of meditation to you, which have never been there before. And it's all just for you. We are going to give you this month a couple of meditation techniques which are going to be longer and longer. So we start with 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and then going up to 30 minutes. And it will have different parts. In the beginning, we will not have all the parts in it, but I want to explain that in this video so that you just get a clear understanding about what we are going to do in this month and the following months, so that you just get into a very precise, immersion into meditation. Yeah, are you ready for that? The first part of what we are going to do is that we are starting our meditation with a special form of Pranayama breathing. So the main aim of the Pranayama are two things. The first thing is that it gives you a clear distinction between before meditation and meditation. So we are just putting our mind into a state where it actually realizes this is now something different. Because what a lot of people do, and probably you had this experience too, you just sit in meditation. In the beginning, it's very exciting when you start to learn it, but afterwards your mind just really gets very used to it, and you're just sitting, and then your mind starts to dream away and think and plan, and you know there's no meditation taking place. So we want to take a clear break between, okay, this is life and this is everything we need to think about in it, and this is something else. So Pranayama, where the technique we'll use is that for 3 seconds we'll breathe in through our nose, just really deeply and calm. And then we are going to hold our breath. So holding the breath immediately brings your mind back to the present moment, because you know your body goes like, what is this? Why is there no oxygen coming? So your attention will be directly with your breath. And then we'll hold the breath for 6 seconds, and then we'll breathe out for 6 seconds. So they have found out if the exhalation is longer than the inhalation, you will activate the parasympathetic nervous system. So that means that the nervous system, which is there for relaxation, which is there for calmness, will be activated through our breath. So super powerful. So you're here in the present moment, you are just calming down tremendously. And what I like to introduce you to is a very, very old healing technique which an old monk here in Thailand taught a friend monk of mine. And what he said is that you imagine that with the inhalation through the highest point of your head, some white light or white energy is entering your body through the spine into your stomach region, and you really breathe in deeply into your stomach. So, and when you hold the breath, you imagine that this bright light is just expanding into every part of your body. And what I do is also that before I start, I feel which parts of my body are a little bit in the background, which can I not feel so good. It's more your subconscious part. So what we try to do is with the inhalation and the holding of the breath, we want to bring the oxygen in every single part of our body, especially where we don't feel so good. So, and then when we breathe out, you take a part of your body or a part of your mind, you know, like when you deal with fear, for example, you see before, where would I feel fear, you know, in your stomach region, or, you know, up here in your throat, or, you know, your chest get tight. So, and then you let the air with the exhalation flow through that. So if the point is below your belly button, you imagine that the energy is flowing through your legs, out of your feet, into the ground, or when it's up from your belly button, you bring it out through your crown chakra or through your hands. Have a look what works best for you. So we start 3 seconds inhalation, and the energy is flowing down your spine into your stomach. 6 seconds, you know, just holding the breath and bringing the energy in every part of your body, and then 6 seconds relaxed, breathing out and taking the negative energy, the contraction and the tension out of your body so that you deeply, deeply relax. This is part one. Part two is the breath of fire. That's also a yogic technique which is tremendously powerful to bring energy into your body. And how we do it is that we bring our arms up, we make a nice fist, and you know, then we breathe in, yeah, and then with the exhalation we bring our arms down and we breathe out strongly through our nose, and our stomach goes very hard inside, and that pushes the energy basically in and up. So, and we'll begin with 20 repetitions, yeah, and then we pause, and then we do a second set of 20 repetition, and then we pause, and then we will just, you know, just bring that up to 30 repetitions, and every time you just imagine that you get more and more power into your body. And so this is the pranayama, and then the breath of fire that we bring the energy up to our heart, to our mind. The third step, we will not have that in the beginning of the meditation, but later on. Then you bring your arm to the outside, yeah? So, and you bring your thumb up, and you look over your thumb and focus on a point in the distance. So a lot of you who have done yoga with me, I usually do that a lot. And then you imagine you have, you know, an arrow, and you put that on your bow, and then you pull the bow. Yeah? So, and then you focus over your thumb on a point in the distance. And what you do is that you imagine something you really want to achieve in your life, especially where fear is keeping you away from achieving that. Yeah, so that, for example, if you're not in a relationship, you know, and something of you is afraid of intimacy because you have experienced in the past something difficult, or you're always, you know, have difficulties and fears to speak up in social situations, social anxiety, what most of us have, you know, just imagine yourself in a state where you don't have that fear anymore, and do the warrior pose and just really focus with your mind on that you say, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to really thrive and really put effort in it. Right. So the Buddha was talking about determination. You know, that's one of the enlightenment factors, that you're so determined to reach your goal and that you're really willing to put a lot of effort into it. Yeah, so that's point number three. So then we're starting with the actual work on fear. So the first thing is that you bring up something which you are afraid of. And please, please, please don't start with your biggest fears and your biggest traumas. You know, don't dive in head first. That is not the right thing to do with anything you do. You know, just start with something small. Start with some social anxiety. Start with some situations where you just really felt uptight. And have a look when you remember these moments. Where do I feel it in my body? What is going on really? So the first base of mindfulness is the physical body, and the second are our emotions. So just really start to learn, really start to more understand what is actually going on in this moment. And then if you come to the point where you just really feel it and where you just remember situations like that, then we start to make the main change. And the main change is point number five, that we are starting to either remembering moments where we have overcome these fears. It's very powerful, because a lot of times we forget that we have been in this situation before and that we are still here. So yeah, we have all experienced breakups in our lives. We all have experienced moments where, you know, things really went down the drain, but we overcame it. You know, we came out of it. We came out of depression. We came out of anxieties and fears and panic attacks and stuff like this. We were able to do that. So why do you think you cannot do it again? And so that's the magic. If you have not, and if you cannot find any situations where you have overcome it, imagine that you overcome it. And that's the second most powerful thing to understand, is the mind cannot distinguish between a memory or an actual experience or your imagination. So the more vivid you can imagine how you overcome the problems and the fears, and the more often you do that, the more powerful it becomes. So you have the power to really change your life by just imagining, and the imagining is as valid as having the experience of overcoming it. So, and the more often you do that, the more often you give your mind the information, I can handle it, I'm in control of it, I can do it. But you need to just really put effort in to remember and do it again and again, again and again. And then the next step is that you just really, really imagine very vividly how it is to feel without this, how it is to live without this fear. That you just really imagine how much more energy you have, how much more opportunities there are in your life, and how much more love you would experience, how much more you can really dive into relationships, dive into, you know, connections with people, to live your life more adventurous. You know, this is what we want when we go traveling. We don't want to just hold back and, you know, stay in our hotel room. We want to go out. We want to make experiences. So just imagine really, really deeply how it is to live without this fear, and you will see that the main thing what changes is that you are able to live with more love, with a much more open heart, because fear brings you away from love. That's the main thing. And the more you will practice this, the more you will see that your heart will open, step by step, meditation by meditation, so that we start to experience, not just think, not just feel, but that we start to experience that the biggest power in life is love, and how it is to live your life based on love. This is what the Mindfulness Project is about. It's only two things. It's just love and freedom. And the question is, whatever you do, whatever, you know, is going on in your life, ask yourself, does it bring me closer to absolute liberation and freedom? And does it bring me closer to love? So I hope you have a wonderful day. Start the second video right away, and we dive into the meditation. We do step one, and then the next weeks we do step two, step three, step four, until you're free. Thank you, guys. I love you.